The Broken Desert. Item Number SCP-132. Object Class Safe. Special Containment Procedures. All instances of SCP-132 are to be cataloged and etched with an appropriate designating mark. SCP-132 is to be stored at Containment Sector blank when not in use. No special clearance is needed to have access to files relating to SCP-132, and instances of SCP-132 may be requisitioned for office decoration in any non-command Foundation installation. After Incident 132-1, no instances of SCP-132 are to leave Containment Area 23 without approval by the Sector Director. Following the incident detailed in Addendum 3, standard classification procedures are reinstated on SCP-132. Description: SCP-132 takes the form of a series of blank glass tetrahedrons, each with a side length of 10.3 centimeters. Each instance of SCP-132 appears to contain a patch of desert sand. Occasionally, scorpions and other desert creatures enter the confines of an instance of SCP-132 as if it were a continuous piece of desert. Creatures within SCP-132 have shown no awareness of the existence of anything outside of the object, and attempts to influence the area within SCP-132 have failed. Review of observed animal life within SCP-132 has proven inconsistent. Clusters of contiguous instances have been internally consistent and have been confirmed to display areas of every major desert. No method of pinpointing exact locations has been discovered. Staff observing SCP-132 are advised to be on the lookout for any defining features that could aid in this endeavor. Test Log SCP-132. Procedure: SCP-132-1 rotated and placed on an upper side. Result: no apparent change in SCP-132-1. Procedure: SCP-132-1 inverted and placed in a cradle. Result: no apparent change in SCP-132-1. Procedure: SCP-132-1 shaken vigorously. Result: a few grains of sand in SCP-132-1 shift as though picked up by a light wind. Procedure: SCP-132-1 shaken vigorously. Result: no apparent change in SCP-132-1. Note: I guess it was just the wind. Better to be sure anyway. Dr. Peterson. Procedure: a corner of SCP-132-1 is filed for several strokes. Result: the filed corner is scuffed in a consistent manner to normal glass. Procedure: heat is applied to the side of SCP-132-1 with a blowtorch. Result: heated side melts, and a sizable hole is cut in SCP-132-1. Desert scene remains. Note: I brought it around in there after it cooled and only felt glass. It would appear that SCP-132 only shows an illusionary desert. I suppose it could be shown a real place, but I've no idea how we could confirm this or locate where that may be. Dr. Peterson. Incident Log 132-1. Dr. R, currently stationed at area blank, reports knocking SCP-132-71 off her desk. Upon impact with the ground, SCP-132-71 shattered, and the office of Dr. Blank was buffeted by extreme winds. Other owners of instances of SCP-132 confirm that the area shown by SCP-132-71 and the adjoining instances was experiencing a sandstorm. Addendum 132-1. Careful observation of SCP-132 has found that many instances are contiguous. The largest section, composed of 16 instances. Speculation over the existence of additional unsecured instances has been raised. Addendum 132-2. Administration has deemed the possible risk of unsecured instances of SCP-132 existing to be negligible and set retrieval efforts to lowest priority. Keywords relating to SCP-132 have been added to routine search protocols. Addendum 132-3. a large box arrived for Dr. Richardson at his home, with a return address of blank, redacted, a Foundation front. No faculty associated with redacted report any association with said box, and it does not appear on any redacted records. Inside were 37 uncatalogued instances of SCP-132. 12 were contiguous with previously documented instances of SCP-132, and 3 instances, which had no known shared edges, were brought into contiguity. Of particular note were 18 instances, which appeared to display Martian soil, 13 of which were found to be contiguous. Addendum 132-4. At Dr. L's suggestion, notes were taken over a year on the light cycle of SCP-132 clusters. Although imprecise, the Foundation now has a rough set of coordinates for various SCP-132 viewing locations. No missions need be sent to confirm these locations, but teams passing near are encouraged to assist Dr. Peterson in pinpointing coordinates.